Very good afternoon, and thanks, Dr. Altaf, sir, and all the organizing committee from Jammu and Kashmir. Saving time, this start my lecture right now. So today I have to talk on ILO-0 application of femoral frame. So as already discussed, not going into details, we must have the basic knowledge of the anatomy, the neurovascular bundle, to avoid any complications. It seems complex, but when we have a good knowledge of anatomy, it becomes very easy. For that, we need to have a basic knowledge of the surface anatomy, the femur. So first, the basic is that we must get knowledge of Kent's line. A Kent's line is a straight line from anterior superior iliac spine to the medial condylar border, as you can see in this here. And lateral to this is a very safe zone in the proximal part, and distal part, the posterior part is unsafe. So we can go safely with this Kent's line. And as already discussed, the sartorius is a guide to the adductor canal. So we can just follow sartorius to avoid any injuries in the vascular bundle. This safe zone, the anatomical part has already very well described earlier. So I'm not going to repeat this. Just to add on, we can also have this diagrams according to the goniometric system of 360 degrees. For this, we have to learn by heart all the angles from which angle we can go safe. With this, we can divide for the upper third and the lower third, the ideal plane, the optimal zone, the safe corridor, and the hazardous corridor. This is for the trochanteric and the subtrochanteric area. This is for the middle part. For the lower part, I usually, for add-on, use the MUDEF method, where the bones has been divided into 8 to 10 parts. Depending on the bone, for femur, we have taken 8 sections here. So using this, if you make a clockwise diagram, so just remember this, in the 12 o'clock is always anterior, whether it is right or left, and 3 o'clock is always in the median. So you can just make 1 to 12 like this, and you can diagrammatically specify which area is safe and not safe, and you can mark also. So here, if you start with level 1, you can see the contraindicated positions are 1 and 4. As you can see here, this is the contraindicated positions, and the very safe positions are 8, 9, 10, and 11. And rest parts are safe position. We can apply pins on this 8, 9, 10, and 11. And if you're an expert, you can apply wires from 12 to 6 or other places also, like 11 to 5. Similarly, in the subtrochanteric area of femur, the contraindicated positions are 1, 2, 3, and 4. The reference very safe positions are 8, 9, 10, 11. We usually also apply pins over here in this proximal area in order to avoid any complications. And similarly, the safe positions are from 5 to 12. You can safely apply wires if you wish, if you want to go a more wire technique. The proximal femur, similar, the contraindicated positions are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The medial part is not safe, and the lateral part is safe. Mid-shaft, similarly, we have 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can see these are unsafe zones. And the safe positions are, the more safe are for 8, 9, and 10. And we can, from 1 to 12 are safer. You can, if you're an expert, you can go with wires, as you can see in the diagrams, with the diagrams. Similarly, in the lower femur, 3, 4, 5 and are contraindicated. Rest are safe positions. You can still apply here pins. I apply pins from the lateral side. You can also apply anteromedial wires from here. From 11 to 5, you can apply wires. In level 6, the lower part of the femur, the contraindicated positions are 4 and 5. The reference positions are 3, 7, 8, and 9. And the safe parts are 1 to 12. So you can also see here in the posterior middle, the vessels come in the posterior middle segment. So you can go safely the lateral, the anteromedial, and the posterior lateral part. Similarly, in the supracondylar area, the mainly neurovascular bundle is in the posterior medial part. So rest parts you can go very safe with pins and wires or combinations, as you can see in the diagram. Level 7 is next level is the condylar area, where the mostly the neurovascular bundles are in posterior part. So you can go very safe from lateral to medial, oblique from posterior medial to posterior lateral, as you can see in the diagram. So if you have a good knowledge of this diagram, you can go very safe. I have just made a gist of this. Like in the proximal part, trochanteric area, you can apply two pins from the lateral part, or you can go on a wire from anterior to posterior. As you can see, I've made just making the series of diagrams. The green part is very safe. You can make pins for here. Yellow part is comparatively safe. You can go with wires for this. And the red is totally contraindicated. This is for the proximal part. The proximal shaft, you can apply two pins from the lateral part and a wire from the anteromedial to posterolateral, and another from posteromedial to anterolateral in between the vascular and neurovascular bundles. If you have a very good and safe knowledge of this anatomy and this diagrams. Lower part, the angles are a little different, similar in the posterior part. You can see, you can put wires like this. So instrumentation has always been, already been described very well. This is the armamentarium that you have to keep in your OT. For femur, we usually, for the middle part, we use full rings, 180, 160, 200 rings. And for the proximal part, we use the arches, femoral arches, so that because we cannot apply a full ring in this area. And to support, we can give oblique support for this. And the distal part, to keep the knee movements free, we can use 5x8 rings. These are different plates and hinges you can use for the assembly in the femoral frame. These are the tensionometers. We can take the patient on a usual traction table, or also we can apply traction with these rings, so that we get easily all the CM images in this position. So this is the usual frame assembly in the proximal area, in the trochantic area. We use arches, we use multiple pins. Use if there is a fracture in the proximal part or a fracture in the mid part or in the distal part. So arches for the proximal part, 5x8 rings or half rings in the proximal thigh, so that we don't give any injury or impingement to the genitals. In the mid part, we can use full rings, and the distal part we use usually use 5x8 rings to avoid any knee stiffness. So here, this is the diagram that shows the usual assembly in this case. Depending on whether you are going to handle a proximal femur area, mid shaft, or distal femur area, is there infection, non-union, fracture, the assembly almost remains the same, adding on more wires to it. So if it is a distal, we can just place two oblique wires in the distal part, very safe. Apply rings on it. On it, we can apply pins, oblique pins. After that, to avoid stiffness, we can just give a full movement to the knee. Then put on the second ring over this area. Put on the rods. You can just again apply, to be very safe, a hybrid, like two lateral pins and oblique directions. And one wire, if you have good knowledge, from anteromedial to posterolateral. Similarly, we can apply in the proximal part, a half ring or full ring. Pins and wires in the same direction, taking care of the vascular bundle is very important. In the proximal part, we connect with an arch, and this is the oblique support that you can see that gives strength to the whole assembly. And depending upon the fracture, we can add multiple pins as required as fracture. For deformity corrections, the assembly remains almost same. We can take help of olive wires and hinges if you have to do an acute correction or a gradual correction with olive wires. We can do a gradual correction over the ring like this. If there is a translation, as you can see in the x-rays, after applying the rings, if there is an acute fracture, we can reduce it acutely, or you can take help of plates to do it a gradual correction. You can also do compression and distraction as needed after applying the ring with the help of rods or distractors. Or if there is limb shortening, we can do lengthening with the same. But normally the corticotomy level in femur we do is either subtrochondric or the suprachondral area, the metafascial diafascial junction. So this is the usual frame assembly, as you can see in the diagram. We do. This is a normal frame assembly using arches and hinges and oblique support for the frame. In the first case, because this is a case of lengthening, so I've not applied any pins in the between. Second case was a case of bad injury, so this is the usual case, applied pins on the proximal part, lower part, and wires in the lower part. So always remember two finger breath rule. After applying the ring, you should have a minimum gap of two finger, so to avoid any skin impingement. these are the usual configuration we can use in all the femoral ring applications, like in the proximal femur part, like this, the subtrochantric area, the midshaft area, for fracture, for dissection. So remember these figures for this, for the distal shaft, and for the condylar area, for the condylar fracture. If there is a fracture in the condylar area, we have to add on tibial rings to stabilize the joint. The usual indication becomes for femur is non-union, osteomyelitis, compound fractures, deformity, limb shortening, limb length discrepancy, amputation, stem lengthening, and more. As you can see in the different diagrams, just to show a few cases, it's a case of infected non-union, case of crush injury, bad crush injury, very bad, you cannot play a nail or plate. So skin graft was done, X-rays are applied, but healing was not yet complete. This went into non-union. So over this, we applied Elizaro, gave up a few cycles of accordion. You can see the ring. See the same assembly is there, united well. So this is the assembly. You should just remember these figures. After removal, patient can walk well in the artificial limb. Similar case for non-infected non-union distal femur. Patient can walk next day if the frame is very stable. In trauma cases, if it is a compound open trauma, you can use Elizaro frames assembly like this. It is almost a total wire and one pin technique because it's in the distal part. Wound has united well, patient can walk next day. So few very basic ring assembly, if you remember, the application of Elizaro and femur is not at all difficult. Similar case of compound trauma, bone loss is there. Bone was replaced and compression is being given. Transport will be given with time in this case. Elizaro and limb lengthening can be used directly with the Elizaro on, or we can also do lengthening over nail in this case. So you can see nail was applied on the Elizaro, the proximal infranaut locked, and after lengthening, the ring was removed and the nail was locked. So it can be done very easily with Elizaro and ring or Elizaro alone. Pre-op and post-op deformities. Walk, you can see there's no limp after surgery. In deformity, you can use Elizaro for proximal femur, distal femur. I'll just show one case. This is a post-traumatic deformity. It's limb shortening. We always do for a femur or tibia, I always do a scanogram. So I always do a scanogram to calculate and use a Bone Ninja application to calculate all the deformities and lengthenings. This is very, makes life very easy. So these are the usual formula for limb deformities. You should always remember these angles, the basic angles, the basic landmarks, the mechanical axial deviation. Not going in detail, the formula of MAP, the ABC given by Heisenberg, the Baltimore team. You can do a calculation with this. If you put a nail, it will be shortening. You can put a Elizaro and do correction. You can do the correction and deformity and lengthening with the Elizaro and hinges or with ACV also. Correction with ACV was done, ortho ACV was done, the hexapod was done in this case. After that, it was removed and LRS was applied. Panosteomyelitis with fracture, pathological fracture, similar ring was applied. So post-op rehabilitation is very important in all the cases. Post-op walk, post-op exercise is very important. So ask the patient to walk, walk and walk if you have done a very good stable surgery. So if you have good knowledge of Elizaro, you can do in all the cases. Thanks to all my mentors who have taught me Elizaro. Thank you. Thanks a lot.